Hello and welcome. In this video, we are going to cover the different types of reports that can be run using OpenManage Enterprise. To do this, we'll need to go to Monitor and Reports, and this will bring us to the Reports screen. OpenManage Enterprise has a selection of built-in reports that provide certain types of data. This is common data that we feel like customers will want or need from the tool. So we've provided these 23 different reports so that they can run the report and or email the report to themselves and pull the data from OpenManage Enterprise. To see the properties of some of these alerts, we could click on the alert and then we could click on run. And it will run the report and provide the data. There's a couple of different options. There's another option where we can run an email. What this will do is run the report in the background and email it to the email address that's provided. We could see what the report, how the report is built and what the fields are that are selected for this report over here on the right-hand side. And then of course, we can also build custom reports by clicking the Create button. So custom reports require names, and you can give it a description of what you want this report to do. And then you click Next, and this is where we have our report builder. So we have multiple categories we can choose from: alerts, devices, groups, jobs, and servers. These categories are shared throughout OpenManage Enterprise in different locations as well. There's device groups, so we can select the different types of groups, and this will help us filter down or narrow down what we want to choose from in our report. And then we also have the ability to create a filter. You'll notice this filter is pretty common to most filters where, you know, you're going to pick your type. you'll pick the type, and then you'll be given your standard operators, you know, greater than, less than, equal to, begins with, and things of that nature. And you can, you know, you can type in different things that apply to your environment. This field here must apply to the environment in order for it to apply to the report. You can also add, you can do an and or as you create more filters. So this gives you the ability to, you know, as a user or a customer, you have the ability to, you know, get pretty granular with this filter functionality. I'm gonna click cancel out of that for now and show you the device columns. The device columns are created by the device groups and the devices that we chose above. You'll notice by default, we have device name, device service tag, and device model clicked. We can remove those if we don't want those in the report. And then we could add whatever filters we want to add. For instance, we could add, you know, chassis DNS name, chassis location, chassis controller. You know, if we were wanting to build a report off of chassis data, I don't have any chassis discovered in this environment, so creating a report on chassis data would not provide us anything useful. In fact, it will not provide us anything at all. Why don't we go ahead and let's run this report. So I click finish, and that creates the report. It was on the first screen. Test 2. So if I click on this and I click run, we will see that no data is provided. And the reason no data is provided is because there are no chassis in this environment to run reports against. So we need to be careful when we're building reports and make sure that we're choosing categories that apply to our environment. So for instance, we'll go ahead and create another report with correct data. Leave the description blank, and we'll leave all for devices. And then, for instance, we can choose something that we have, server chassis, you know, device name, device service tag, device model. So these are all in the report by default, and of course we can remove those, but we'll go ahead and use device name, service tag, model, and we'll go ahead and click on finish, and it will create that report. It looks like that report will be on the second page. Yes, here it is. So if we click on test and then we click on run, it builds the report and it gives me the information of the one device I had in my environment that meets the criteria. So I have a device name, device service tag, and device model presented here. I can download this report in one of four formats and it will download it to my local machine, or I can click email and I can send an email to whoever I would like to, as configured by my SMTP server that OpenManage Enterprise is using. This concludes the reporting feature of OpenManage Enterprise. Thank you.